Hi, my name is Chris Johnson, and I'm the project manager for the Orion Capsule Parachute Assembly Project. What you are about to see in this video is the third Engineering Development Unit airdrop test performed on February 29, 2012 at the U.S. Army Yuma Proving Grounds. This is the third in a series of the most flight-like parachute tests to date with a representative parachute compartment for the Orion spacecraft, and is the first to use a capsule shape representing the Orion spacecraft called a parachute test vehicle. This particular test examined how the wake from the Orion spacecraft would affect the performance of the parachute system. The wake is the disturbance of the airflow behind the vehicle. Parachutes optimally perform in smooth air that allows the proper lift. A wake of choppy air can reduce the parachute inflation performance. This test will be the first conducted with a representative Orion crew module wake in consideration using the full-size vehicle and complete system. The test hardware was extracted from a C-17 aircraft supported by the U.S. Air Force at an altitude of 20,000 feet above the U.S. Army Yuma Proving Grounds. The sequence is followed by a separation of the parachute test vehicle from the pallet. Programmer parachutes are deployed, which set up the right conditions to begin the spacecraft parachute deployment. The Orion spacecraft drogue parachutes are then deployed between 15,000 and 20,000 feet. This is followed by the pilot parachutes, which then deploy the main landing parachutes. There were 17 parachutes deployed during this test. 9 were test technique related, and 8 were Orion system parachutes. In this particular test sequence, you can see the programmer parachutes releasing from the Orion spacecraft, and then the actual sequence of the Orion system begins with the deployment of the drogue parachutes. After the drogue parachutes decelerate the vehicle, they are released, and then the sequence of the pilot parachutes pulling out the main parachutes is started. Here again shows a snapshot of the drogue parachutes being released, followed by the pilot parachutes being deployed. When they inflate, they then pull out the main parachutes from the spacecraft, which begins the main parachute inflation sequence. The main parachutes, once they are deployed, then inflate through 2 stages to full inflation, and they decelerate the vehicle to approximately 25 feet per second, well below the maximum design touchdown speed of the spacecraft. We also recover the pallet hardware, which then we reuse for subsequent testing. The testing is accomplished by a team of disciplined experts in parachute hardware, systems integration, simulation, and modeling, testing and operations, and safety and quality. Their contribution to the development testing is instrumental in paving the way for final production of flight units for the MPCV Orion crew module.